January 26, 2018, a female party became a victim to Wailuku River's dangerous waters.
We got called just before sundown. We responded up there. Of course, we're always hoping we can, you know, rescue instead of recover. So we were doing our best to get up there as fast as we can, get things mobilized, get all our equipment and gear on scene. We did what we had to do, or what we could do, per the conditions that evening.
All attempts to locate and recover the victim were unsuccessful.
Every night, when the last of the men came in, they would make certain to come over to us and give each one of us a hug and words of encouragement about finding Kelly.
And they extended the search, you know, beyond our normal operations to try and bring closure for the family.
As you get to know the family, you want to bring them closure. You know, that could be our family, our friend.
And after many days of extended rescue, the mission was suspended. Not being able to locate this missing person was not only tragic for the family, but for the rescuers involved as well.
And that this was their only daughter. And that kind of hit me. That hit me hard, you know.
Without any success of finding our victim, it was a feeling of emptiness.
On February 24, 2018, approximately 1 month later, we received a report that someone had jumped off of Rainbow Falls.
So we got the call that somebody, you know, somebody had witnessed someone jumping off of Rainbow Falls. The weather had been bad for a few days already. And to think that somebody would jump off, you know, we were surprised that call even came in.
This was during a time of heavy rains and the river was extremely swollen and flash flooding was occurring.
It was pretty dangerous. A lot of water moving and things like that working along the edge of the river there.
You know, it was heavy, heavy downpours, you know, because it was raining so hard. The chopper had to set down during the heavy periods of rain. The chopper was able to fly only intermittently.
Upon arrival and investigation, it was determined that this was not a call for a new victim, but possibly the missing person from the month before.
It let up a little bit. Chopper 1 got airborne again and continued searching. They said they spotted the body.
The victim's body had been located by Chopper 1, but was trapped in a heavy whirlpool and river rapid situation that prevented any type of extrication. The decision was made to wait and see if the body would be released by this whirlpool and could be recovered downstream. However, after waiting for over an hour, it was obvious that we were not going to get the break we were hoping for. The river was becoming more swollen and violent, and the threat of a flash flood more likely due to the persistent heavy rain.
So we're starting to lose some daylight.
It was becoming clear that we weren't going to get an opportunity if we just wait. You know, the conditions weren't getting any better.
With nighttime approaching, we came together as a team and decided that if we were able to secure the victim's body in some way, we could have a chance at a successful recovery when the river calmed down.
But I was told there was no stopping the team from risking their own lives to recover Kelly.
Conditions again were pretty crazy, so I know the guys the night before did what they had to do.
It had been raining all evening, so everything was muddy.
And the personnel from Station 2 rappelled down the bank of the river over two 15-foot vertical sections to a ledge at the river's edge.
When we made the decision to intervene and to recover Kelly, my role was in the front at the end of the rope.
You know, he basically was hanging suspended over the edge, and just every time he would get an opportunity, he would try and make a grab. You know, he secured the upper torso, and it was as best as we could do at the time.
The decision was made to suspend the mission and return at first light to continue the operation.
We came back in the next morning, and it was very muddy.
Being on a rescue team is unique because everybody has their strengths and weaknesses. When you work together, you know, you can accomplish something that you most likely wouldn't have been able to do without the rest of the team.
The river conditions had subsided, and we were able to make a successful recovery.
Having the ropes and the system set up and getting everything, you know, put in place takes a little bit of time, but we were able to do it effectively and safely, and that was kind of the thing that we were able to do because we have the certain equipment that we have and, you know, the things that are provided for us.
We use a lot of the equipment that the Sayres have gotten for us, you know. We used all the rope rescue stuff that they got for us, our baskets, our ropes, and all the mechanical advantages.
I appreciate the fact that Frank and Laura provide, you know, equipment to the Sayre Foundation.
I'd like to thank the Sayre Foundation for their ongoing and continuous efforts to make our jobs safer.
I'd like to say how grateful we are to everyone at the fire department, at the Sayre Foundation, to Kyle and Robin for everything that they did for us. You are all Kelly's heroes. You are our heroes. May God bless you and keep you safe and out of harm's way. We love you all. Mahalo.